Welcome to video number 10 of Articy's First Steps tutorial series. The topic of this video is items. We will create item templates and entities and see how items can be managed in our game with the help of global variables. I already imported all assets we need for the second mission. That means we can dive right into the item templates. First, we should think about what kind of items we will have in our game and plan out how many features will be needed for that. For the start, we will have some general items Lily can carry around or equip. Weapons, so Lily can defend herself from dangers on faraway planets. Some items that will be used specifically with pets. And a third type of items in regards to the spaceship. Let's start with a basic item feature. In this feature, we will put all properties we need for all our items, like item type, weight and value, or the information if the item is a quest item. For weapons, we create a new feature. Here we need properties like min and max damage and weapon range. Next, we add a feature that deals with properties specific to pet items. Here we have some values to track modifications to the pet's hunger, thirst, or playfulness. Last but not least, the feature for the spaceship items. Here we have properties for stuff like jump capacity if we have a ship drive, or armor rating for an improved plating. Now that we have the features, we can create item templates. We use the basic item feature for all templates and add the second feature depending on the item type. The next step are the item entities. We need a couple of items, which the player can use on the next mission, find on the planet's surface, or might receive as a reward. Create an entity, select preview image and template, and fill out the details. After creating the item entities, I quickly added the other necessary entities for the mission as well. The NPC Mr. Starvas, his paid Ecclesiars, and a potential enemy, a red lizard. Now we have our items, but we still need a way to manage which items the player currently has with them. There are a couple of ways to go about this. For our little game, we will use global variables. Create a new variable set called items. Our items will be variables within the set. Each item will be created as a Boolean variable with a default value of false. False means that Lily does not have the specific item currently. If she is supposed to receive an item at one point in the game, we can set the corresponding variable value to true via an instruction. If we later implement the system into the game engine, we have a simple but elegant way to track the game's items. This will be all for this video. In the next one, we'll take another look at scripting, while creating a way for the player to spend their skill points, and while preparing the dialogue for mission 2. As always, if you want to take another look at your project, just download the project files and check them out in Articy Draft 3. You can find the link in the video description. Have a great day and see you next time!